Standalone 5G versus non-standalone 5G. What's the difference? So, hey everyone, Alex Moen here with today's BizTech Tips. And you've probably heard about all the cool things that 5G can do or will enable in the future. So like expanding Internet of Things, helping with self-driving cars, augmented reality, virtual reality. And 5G is going to really help expand this. But you might have noticed certain carriers and networks starting to use the term standalone 5G. So T-Mobile, for instance, just announced they're officially the first one to have nationwide standalone 5G available in all 50 states. So to note the differences, you have to know that carriers have two different options for how they can deploy 5G. So most of their networks right now are built around 4G. So all the towers, all the structures and everything in the background is really geared towards that. So if they just put in 5G on top of that, it's a little bit easier for them, and there aren't as many 5G users currently. That is what non-standalone 5G is, but standalone 5G, they just build everything separate and specifically for it. So it's a little bit better overall for standalone 5G. It'll have ultra low latencies. You'll be able to be a little bit more efficient. It'll ultimately save costs in the long run and open up all those other things that we're talking about. Non-standalone 5G, again, it just can't handle as many users. It can't slice it up for all the different, you know, separate use cases, and it's all kind of being mishmashed together, and it's not quite as perfected or as efficient as if it were built specifically for 5G.